Two members of the Brazilian Army Language Center visited the Defense Language Institute Foreign Language Center October 22 to 26, to gain knowledge about the inner workings of one of the largest foreign language schools in the nation.
I'm Lieutenant Colonel Sergio Avelar Tinoco, Commandant of the Brazilian Army Language Center, in Portuguese, Centro de Idiomas do Exército.
The Brazilian Army Language School was stood up about 3 years ago with an average of some 200 students attending per year and 30 to 40 teachers.
In Brazil, we have military teachers, so they are already an English, a French, or a Spanish teacher. Then they join the military by taking an exam and taking a one-year course. Then they become military language teacher.
Languages taught there include English, Spanish, German, French, Italian, Russian, and Portuguese for foreigners.
I'm Captain Vilas Boas. I'm the head of the English department at the Brazilian Army Language School.
The visitors pointed out that the aim of their tour was to learn more about the methods DLIFLC uses to produce such highly proficient linguists in 17 foreign languages.
Actually, I learned English through the audiolingual method, which was initially created here. It was known as the Army method. And then when I joined the Army, when I decided to take the Spanish proficiency test, I took advantage of your online resources, GLOSS. And I was really successful based on the studies I took using that resource. And besides that, I had two tours in Haiti as a French and Creole interpreter. And I used the language survival kit to help me to improve my skills in Creole. So, and now knowing that DLIFLC is at the forefront of language teaching, I decided to come here to learn some more and to improve my skills both as a teacher and as a language learner, and try to take this innovation to our language school in Brazil.
He knows Portuguese and Spanish already, and yeah. So he's here to learn French.
I see. Yeah.
One of the key stops of the Brazilian Army School delegation made was to acquaint themselves with the Foreign Area Officer program that is responsible for all FAOS studying at DLIFLC or the neighboring Naval Postgraduate School.
When our officers are sent abroad, they work in a similar basis to your FAOS. They are going to be a military attaché, the NCOs as an auxiliary of military attaché. We have also instructors and students in other friendly nations.
During their stay, the officers spent time visiting classrooms, talking with instructors and administrators, but also spending time with students, sitting in on their classes, eating lunch and finding out about their daily routine.